Oh, we fell in love with her on the hit TV series Growing Pains, but when the cameras stopped rolling, Tracy Gold was fighting demons of her own and found herself embroiled in a family feud with one of her co-stars. She's opened up like never before, and our very own Angela Bishop has the story.
She was a child actor from the tender age of four.
Hey, you're even prettier than on TV.
Show me that smile again.
But Tracy Gold only became a household name when she scored the role of straight-A student Carol Seaver on the hit TV series Growing Pains.
Could be a dream come true.
When you first got the part in Growing Pains, what was it like?
When I auditioned for Growing Pains, at first I didn't get it. Oh. There was a different Carol Seaver for the pilot, and they cast somebody else because they didn't think that I was like bookwormy enough and stuff like that. When they shot the pilot, then they tested it and they recast the part. They realized they wanted a different Carol Seaver, and so then I went in and auditioned for it again multiple times and did like chemistry tests with Kirk Cameron, and I ended up getting it. So it was literally, I went to like to read for the network, got a call, I got the part, and I was doing a TV Guide photo shoot that afternoon.
Wow.
So it was a whirlwind.
But there's nothing to worry about. I'm almost 13.
Now, Missy Gold, your sister, was already in Benson.
She was on Benson.
And so you knew a little bit of what it could be like.
Uh-huh. I had also auditioned for Benson, and Missy got it. And then...
Was that tough?
No, not at all, actually. You know, I was working a lot as a kid before I got Growing Pains.
Yep.
I was doing a lot of movies of the weeks and stuff like that, so I was always working, just didn't have a consistent kind of place where people knew me, and I was famous, so I was fine with it. I think other people thought, like, oh, she must be jealous, but I really wasn't. And then when the last season of Benson was the first season of Growing Pains.
Right.
So we sort of traded spots a little bit, and it was fun, and I used to love going to the Benson set. I considered them family, and I would hang out there all the time. I was like, this is great.
You're safe as long as you're with me, because I'm a guest.
It says here that as the universe expands, all matter is slowly degenerating into a state of total disorganization.
The first few years of Growing Pains were like magic. I mean, it was like, it was amazing. It was just, I couldn't wait for Monday. I couldn't wait like just to get back on the set. I loved everybody. It was so fun. And it just was, it was such a unique, amazing, really great experience.
But soon, all those bright lights began to dim.
You know, towards the latter couple years of Growing Pains, you know, it was not quite the shiny new thing, a fun thing, as fun, and we got different producers, and there just were some changes and things like that. So I think it became a little bit different during that time, and for me personally, it was just, I was struggling at that time.
This has to be some mistake!
I had gained a little bit of weight, and I had never had a weight problem before, so, you know, all of a sudden I gained a little bit, and it wasn't even that big a deal. But the producers wrote in jokes, and they were saying, well, it's brother-sister banter, and you don't have any brothers, you don't know what it's like. But it really hurt my feelings, because when you make fun of Carol Seaver, you make fun of Tracy Gold, because it's my body. And so I would, like, negotiate with them. So that was a tough time. I would sort of dread getting a script and being like, how many jokes are going to be in there? And there'd be, like, some, I'd be like, all right, I can handle that. And then others, I'd be like, please take it out. It hurts my feelings so bad. And they just didn't really get it, to be honest with you.
Eventually, as the series came to the end, you actually had to step back. You actually had to go and get help.
Yes, on the last season, we got back from Christmas break, and I had just really gotten so thin and sick. And they had wanted me to lose weight, and I went on that diet. That's what led to the anorexia. And so then finally, about a year later, they call me in, and they're like, you've lost too much weight. It was really ironic to me. I'm like, really? Like, guys, can I not please you? But I was really getting sick at that point, and so they basically said I had to go into a hospital, and I did.
So how big were you when they told you you had to lose weight?
Well, I never like to mention weight, because
okay,
if
enough.
I mention weight, but I'll tell you this much, you would be horrified. You would be like, what?
You were normal.
Yeah.
You were...
I just wasn't TV skinny at that time. And so I was just a normal girl going through Growing Pains.
But did a doctor not put you on the initial diet?
Yeah, so my parents didn't want me to go on some kind of willy-nilly diet, and they wanted me to be under a doctor's supervision. But he basically gave me the option to be on a 500-calorie diet or a 1,000-calorie diet. And I chose the 500 because I'm like, I'll just get it over with, you know? Just lose it quick, be over with. Never thinking that it would ever lead to where it led.
500 calories a day,
yes.
A growing child.
Oh, yep, yep. Yep. Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
He's
still practicing?
You know, I don't know. And he had written a book at that point, and I think he was trying to use me a little bit to kind of further him.
As a success story.
Yes, there you go. But it was funny because when you lose weight, you do think so much that when you lose weight, oh, it's going to be great. Because everybody was like, oh my God, you look so great. You look so beautiful, all this. And you think it would make you feel so good. But it didn't. It really made me feel like doubting myself and embarrassed about the way I looked before. I was like, was I really that bad? Was everyone talking about it? So I sort of then was like, all right, I'll never let that happen again. You know? So it was a rough road.
Tracy used her recovery from anorexia to help others. She's written about her struggles in the best-selling book, An Appetite for Life, and also produced a hit documentary series.
We saved some lives, we really did. And it's something I'm extremely proud of, that show.
Social media as it is today, you get embroiled in all sorts of things. Uh-huh. And recently when Kirk Cameron, your on-screen brother, mentioned in an interview that he was not in favour of marriage equality.
Do I support the idea of gay marriage? No. I don't.
The world suddenly reaches out and wants to ask all his castmates what they think. And you said your thoughts, which are?
Well, my thoughts was equality and love for all. I did it as a simple tweet, and I had already done the No Hate campaign.
Yep.
And so I posted that picture because everybody was asking me, what's your opinion, what's your opinion? And I'm like, silence is worse than anything. And I didn't want to disparage Kirk or get any kind of war of the words. I just wanted to be like, look, he doesn't represent all of us.
Which was then painted as a feud, despite
it
what you said
it
between
was.
You and
And it's funny, it was painted as a feud, and before I knew it, we were on TMZ and Good Morning America, and I'm like, all right, I gotta do something. So I picked up the phone and I placed a phone call to him, and I'm like, you know, Kirk, I'm like, I know you know what's going on. And he's like, yeah, I've seen it. I'm like, I just want you to know, I'm not in a fight with you.
Yeah.
I'm like, they asked my opinion and I gave it just as you did. And he's like, we're good, don't worry.
You have a long marriage in Hollywood terms. You know, is it about 140 years in Hollywood terms, isn't it? What's your secret?
I just married my best friend. I know it's cliche, and I love him, and I still think he's really sexy and cute. And we just really get along and like being with each other. So I think that's it, you know. And I mean, I met him when I was 20, so it's been a long time.
Wow. Well, you must come back to Australia soon, Tracy.
I would love to.
We would love to have you
Absolutely.
On our show. And just think you're the bananas pajamas. So thank you so much. It's another great Aussie
that's
term
awesome.
For you. Really
right.
Nice to meet
thank
you.
Thank you. So nice
thank
to
you
meet
so
you.
Much.
What a great girl. And how messed up that she had to go through all of that as a kid, but then she fought her way back.
It seems so strange, because I remember having the biggest crush on her or her character on Growing Pains, which was the biggest show going on in the 80s when I was growing up. And to think that at that same time you had producers telling you, oh, you're not skinny enough, you're not attractive enough. Just...
But look at her now.
On so many levels.
Indeed. And a huge thanks as well to The Hollywood Show for that interview with Tracy Gold. Another cracker thanks to the one and only Angela Bishop.